What exactly is this? What did I just spend a couple of weeks making? Whatever it is, it's game-like, but is it even a game? And why do I find these things so compelling? To understand what's happening, let's rewind back to 6-year-old me, sat at home on a rainy day, nothing to do except this. Maybe it was just me being a weirdo, but what I would do is pick a raindrop and race it against the others. Anyway, there was something strangely satisfying about this. Fast forward to the 2020s. The world is a changed place. Cars are sleeker, buildings are taller, and people carry tiny computers with them, which for some reason are called phones, but no one can quite remember why. Another thing that might seem weird to a pre-internet kid is people watching videos of marble races. Lots and lots of people, it turns out. And then we have the natural evolution of this. If you simulate marble races on computer, you can add all kinds of fancy things not possible in real life. You can even create epic battles between two sides, fueled by the motion of marbles through crazy contraptions. And it's this style of video that most reminds me of racing raindrops, the invented stakes, the mini narratives, and the big comebacks. So as a game designer, I had a natural instinct. I wanted to make one. So let's do just that. Many creators use Algadoo to make these videos since it requires very little coding, but I think Unity is going to be a better choice for me. Still, if you're absolutely allergic to coding but want to play around with some physics, Algadoo is free on Windows and Mac and seems pretty fun. Let's get started then. But first, we need a way to be able to draw stuff and make it work in Unity's physics. I'm really liking Affinity Designer for vector design at the moment, and from here I can just throw it over to Unity as a bitmap. Unity can create physics shapes from bitmaps automatically, and that's going to save a bunch of time. Toss in a few marbles and a simple mixer mechanism, and we're on our way. This is going to be an epic battle between two sides on the left and right, so we need to make symmetrical paths for the marbles. Let's create a couple of pachinko sections with buckets underneath, and then when the marbles fall into the buckets, they'll trigger the attacks. Next, we're going to need some cannons. I'm using the same code that I used for the mixer at the start to make the cannons angle up and down, which will add an element of timing to the battle. Using trigger boxes again, I've made it so that the marbles respawn in the mixing section when they fall into the buckets after they trigger their actions. If this is going to be a battle, both sides are going to need shields. I could place all these hexagons by hand, but that would be insane, so I'm doing it the good old lazy way, in code. So we have some targets to shoot at. Now we just need to do the shooting. Let's throw up some simple bullets. We're going to want big flashy weapons in the end, but this is a good start. Oh, and what's this rotatey thing in the middle? The idea is that marbles can randomly fall into it and it will collect them until something tips the whole thing up, hopefully turning the tide of battle either one way or the other. Keep an eye on that mechanism when you watch your final video. Let's add another important wrinkle. Marbles can now have number values. Each marble starts as a 1, but when it falls into the right bucket, that number can be increased by 1 or doubled. And then, when a marble falls into an action bucket, it triggers the same number of actions as its value. This really helps to add drama, because it's fun to keep your eye on big numbers, especially if they swap sides, or fall back into the mixer. With the numbers out of the way, let's get down to building out the attack and defense. On the attack side, I changed the bullets into rockets, which speed up over time and have a bit of a random element to their steering. I did this by creating a thruster component which continually adds a force to a physics object, and I added a random wiggle to the direction of the force. The result is something a bit more visually interesting than the previous bullets. The cluster weapons break into smaller bomblets on impact, which means that the point of impact really matters. Add to this the fact that weapons of either side can collide into each other, and you get some interesting interactions. Precise control over what physics objects can collide with each other is provided by Unity's layer collision matrix, and using this we can make sure that whilst weapons of each side can hit each other, they can't hit their own side or the marbles. The last weapon, the spread shot, is really good for decimating wide areas of the opponent's shield or laying down defensive fire. Finally, we need a mechanism for enabling big swings in the balance of combat. The healer bot builds up the shields layer by layer from the outside and makes huge comebacks possible. With all the systems functional, let's go back into the screen design and work on the readability. Similar to esports games like Street Fighter, it's important that the entire battle state is readable from a single screenshot. So let's add some queues for the weapons and repair bots so we can see what's queued up for both sides. But how is the battle going to end? What we need is a win state, so let's add health to the cannons. Unlike the shields, the health can never be regenerated, so damage is permanent. Alright, let's tweak the visuals by adding some post effects and a coloured outline around the two halves of the screen to show which side each belongs to. This again helps with that all-important readability, helping to teach the audience how all the parts relate to each other. Right, let's take a step back for a moment. What we're designing here is a linear experience, kind of like a TV show. So we need a way to shape the narrative and add ever-increasing stakes as the video progresses. To that end, let's add a timed unlocking system which unlocks weapons progressively. This should help build a spectacle throughout the video, as well as making the viewer curious about the next weapon to be unlocked. Works well. And that's it, we're all done. So how can you watch a finished video? Well, it turns out I like these things so much, I created a whole new YouTube channel dedicated to them. Expect a bunch of these Marble War simulations as well as other weird and wonderful contraptions. No talking, no worn-out memes, just a bunch of strangely hypnotic simulations and some epic beats. The channel is called Thing Machine, and I'll link to the first video here and in the description. So hopefully now we can answer my original question. Is this even a game? It has no user interaction, it's just a video, but then again, was this a game? To be honest, I couldn't care less about categorizing these things. They're fun, and that's enough for me. And making one was a challenging design exercise. If you want to dabble in systemic design where every single piece affects the system as a whole, you can do a lot worse than making one of these things. In the meantime, go and subscribe to Thing Machine. And if you're interested in these kinds of videos, go watch this one next. Bye!